Three sneaky ways fitness coaches can stand out from the crowd using injury prevention. Hey, I'm Sarah from mostmotion, and I'm here with another video for every sports and fitness coach who wants to help their clients avoid all the aches and pains and nagging little problems that stop them from getting the results they want, but also wants to use this to stand out from the crowd. So how can you do that? Well, there's three ways. One is to get ahead of the game. Now, most coaches will wait for the clients to tell them about their problems before they start and do anything about it if they can. But injuries don't start with pain. They start from a lack of movement somewhere in the body, which is often pain-free, and the clients have absolutely no idea it's there. So if you know what to look for, you can do a simple scan of their body language and their postures and their behaviors and instantly get right to the heart of the problem before they can even tell you about it. So while everybody else is stuck waiting for the pain to happen, you can get in there and do something helpful before the pain even starts. So the second thing is to skip to the good bit. I don't like breaking this news to you, but it's true. Your clients do not like doing mobility. They will do it because they know it's helpful, and they will tolerate it because they know it's helpful. But if you give them a choice between getting on with their training and doing the mobility stuff, 99% of them will choose to get on with their training. So if you spend lots of time making them do mobility training, standing around watching them while they're stretching or foam rolling or something like this, they feel like you're putting obstacles in their way. They feel like you're delaying them getting on with their training, and that does not make them happy. So most coaches spend time adding this stuff in because they know it's helpful. But when you know how, you can simply blend injury prevention moves into all of the training that your clients are doing, so you can skip straight to the stuff that they want to be doing and deliver what it is that they need at the same time. So while everybody else is waiting around and doing all this mobility training and spending ages stretching and all this kind of stuff, you can skip past all that and get straight to the training, which your clients will love. So the third thing is to stop focusing on your clients' problems. Everybody's got problems. Nobody wants to focus on these problems. And every time we focus on improving technique or movement pattern problems or something like that, we're reinforcing to our clients that they can't do something. Nobody likes that. Don't forget, pain comes from restricted movement. Restricted movement also causes movement pattern problems, technique problems, all this kind of thing. So if we can find ways of keeping the joints open and moving and get rid of all of these movement restrictions, your client's technique problems will go away, their movement pattern problems will go away, and they're much less likely to be injured as well. So that means you can find super fast ways of improving their technique while everybody else is spending time on repetitive, boring, tedious drills that nobody likes doing. If you can skip past all that and you can get into investigating different types of movement, you can tap into the natural curiosity of the human being and feel like they're playing around with movement instead of focusing on their problems, you are going to stand out a mile from every other coach out there because you're not focusing on your client's problems. So you can learn exactly how to do this in my Smart Coach Education series. And because I haven't really got time to talk to you about all of that right now, you can find a whole bunch of tips and tricks at each stage of what I've just mentioned in my free book. It is completely free. You can go and grab it with the link in the description. It's around here somewhere. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again next time.